We're seeing this weird dichotomy of pockets of labor market tightness amidst millions of people still unemployed. And that's a really unusual kind of situation. The trucking industry in particular already had problems prior to the pandemic because there were limits on who you could hire. One, many people didn't want to be on the road for all that length of time. Many families that had big extended families would rather not be away from home for that long. But also we found problems in crossing states, and as many employers, when the unemployment rate was going down to 3.5% and below that prior to the pandemic, we saw many employers trying to look into things like former felons and people who had been incarcerated to try to bring them back into the labor force, give them a second chance. But of course the trucking industry in particular had a problem with that, about who could travel across state lines and be drivers. So the overall environment in terms of the labor market situation, even though millions are still unemployed, there's a lot of hurdles, particularly for transportation, where they're seeing pockets of literally an inability to find drivers, sometimes at any price. And I think that's one of the big challenges out there.
You're exactly right. As you know, driver recruiting has been an issue. The driver shortage has been an issue for decades and decades. And I'm not sure it's a solvable problem. And it has been exacerbated during this situation. You know, in addition to the pockets of labor shortages you've talked about, as you know, the American Trucking Association and other modes of transportation went to hair follicle testing effective January 1st of 2020, and many drivers were essentially fired because they could not pass those tests, and those drivers are not coming back into the labor pool at all. We've not seen that, and then of course that was exacerbated also by the pandemic. So again, I'm not sure we'll ever solve the driver problem. Carriers have tried to solve it with compensation. That's been helpful some. They tried to solve it with drivers under 21 who served in the military. That's not been as much of a help as we thought it might be. So once again, I'm not sure we're going to solve this issue anytime soon.
Sadly, I tend to agree with you on that. It is a pocket where there has been labor market tightness. The only thing I can say out there is it is also an opportunity cost, right, for people who can't get drivers, because right now we do have these bottlenecks. We do have higher charges on freight. And at some point in time, we're seeing, you know, right now we're starting to unleash that pent-up demand in services, which doesn't mean the driver shortage will go away or the demand will go away, but some of the high rates that many of the carriers are seeing will begin to dissipate a bit. These are bottlenecks that will play out over time. And that's something that, you know, not having a person in place means you've lost that opportunity as well.